question on my community tab on YouTube. There was a poll about mental illness. I've actually been asking lots of questions to get to know everyone better. I'm doing something where I'm doing 10 different polls where I'm getting to know you with different questions, different kinds of things. And one of them recently was a serious question related to mental illness. So that's what we're actually going to be talking about today. So I appreciate it, all of you writing back in comments and participating in the poll. I myself have dealt with quite serious mental illness in my life. It's been the hardest part of my life by a long shot.
On one side of my family in particular.
emotions and things in a way where you feel like you've got to do these things to please God, but really it's not God asking you to do any of those things. And it's very confusing, especially if the onset is when you're young and you have no idea what's going on, which was the case for me. I'll get into other facets of that, but the particular family member that is dealing with something right now is dealing with something that is called schizoaffective disorder. Schizoaffective disorder is a combination of basically schizophrenia and bipolar, like a mood disorder. So it's those two things basically combined. I've done a lot of research over the last few years because of my family member. This is an immediate family member of mine, so we actually have always known that our brains just kind of worked the same way, and we suffered with a lot of similar thought patterns, thought disorders, but at the time when we were younger, we didn't know what they were. We didn't know what a thought disorder was. We didn't know anything. We just knew we were both suffering in similar ways because we're very open with each other and really good friends, and knew that he was like the only person that would understand me, and vice versa. That said, this person ended up going on medication. He was originally put into a mental hospital for mental illness or behavioral center, for something quite serious. He had some delusions, and they led to actions that were harmful to him, and so our family had to have him be hospitalized. This was actually a long time ago, and we still didn't really have an idea of what was going on. He was in there for about a month, and when he came out, long story short, he ended up on a medication that really helped, and I kid you not, really didn't deal with it for probably 12, 13 to 15 years. It was like maybe subtle in the background, some small things, but it was not affecting his life at all. And any kind of maybe some delusions that he had had or this or that in those years were not things he acted on. Or let me tell you some of the symptoms of schizoaffective disorder. So you've got the symptoms of schizophrenia, which are hallucinations, whether they're visual, auditory. Apparently some people have different like taste, different sensations that are hallucinations, they're things that aren't there. No one else is experiencing them or seeing them, feeling them, tasting them. And yeah, so that's one. The second one is delusions, and that's where you believe something that is clearly to anyone else in reality not true. So you might believe you are Jesus, you might believe you're saved. anything incorrect. This has been a couple of years of learning for me, but I'm sure many of you have been learning for much longer, so feel free to correct me if there's something that I might be off on or you've heard differently. Maybe not just heard differently, I've actually researched and done quite a bit of talking to psychiatrists, my own psychiatrist even, about it. So there's that. Now, based on this, this is what my family member was diagnosed with. They've been diagnosed back and forth between schizoaffective disorder and bipolar disorder through the years in different hospitalization times, because they're exhibiting different symptoms each time, and the psychiatrist has had to go off of what they've seen at the moment because this person has not had consistent care from a psychiatrist. They've just gone into behavioral centers when it's gotten really bad. From what I can see now with my family member and their experiences, I definitely see all the signs of schizophrenia. I think there have been signs at time of some mania and depression, but I don't know. Like I said, it's not one size fits all. This is just kind of an idea, so you know what I'm talking about. But basically, my family member got on medication, and interestingly, it wasn't even an antipsychotic, which usually would be what would help someone with this condition, this disease. It was Prozac, and Prozac is really good for a few things, but with a higher dose of Prozac, it's really good for OCD. And it's helpful with anxiety and depression as well. My family member ended up being put on a good sized dose of it and was on it for, like I said, between 12 and 15 years without. Happened for him. He has had symptoms. people or prophets, things like this. There have been several that he has believed about himself. Often people with these delusions will feel like they have a special assignment from God, and it's like outside of reality, though, because a lot of us do have, say, a special thing that maybe God has called us to, but this is outside of reality, okay? If that makes sense. So, like, they're believing they're Jesus, for example, you know, like, that's not what's happening, you know, that's not possible or realistic yet. So, that was going on for him. He also is having some kind of hallucinations, which he's not comfortable telling anyone about. He's keeping a lot of secrets, and he's not sharing with anyone but this one person in his life that is kind of on the same page as him. And, so it's been a very complicated, very tricky situation. It feels like you're walking on eggshells because you can't really say anything to my family member that would imply anything that he does not believe is true without a fairly firm response. Example. is gone, the suffering only is gone after this life on earth. So, and you can see for yourself many examples in the Bible of Christian suffering, having physical ailments and God not healing them for a reason. I won't go into all those details because that's a whole nother subject, but the reason I bring it up is because my family member has been brought into a group of Christians that believes this very heavily. It's so heavily believed by this group that if you are to say something to my family member or someone in this group that they might have a mental illness, they will like rebuke you. Rebuke what you just said in the name of Jesus. That's not true. Don't. And they actually don't even want you to say the words out loud. This part is very new agey to me. The belief that if you just say it out loud, that it will come to pass. That's not at all something that you see in scripture, in the Bible. So I feel that's a very new age belief, this concept of like manifesting good or bad, that if you say something bad out loud about your body, I feel sick, I'm sick, then you are sick. It's quite extreme what my family member believes. And so if you try to talk to them about this or say, it was a new journey for me, and I also believed, unfortunately, in the beginning time of following Jesus, that some of the symptoms I was having of mental illness were spiritual, because I was young, I had no direction, I didn't have anyone talking to me about mental illness, and I didn't have people in my family that had followed Jesus, so I was just like, what is going on? And the time that I started following Jesus was mid-teens, actually. And that's usually about the time that if you do have maybe a mental illness, that the onset is typically in your teens to early 20s. Start to experience symptoms. It's not typically like suddenly onset when you're like 50, like it's usually probably between sounds like you have a cold, they'll be like, in the name of Jesus, I don't have a cold. And it's like, but your nose is running. Just because you say you don't doesn't mean you don't. Like, it's been extreme. And so my HUD is like heavy, because I experienced portions of this when I was young. Conversations with my family member. This is over FaceTime. spiritual things that were very real and were not mental illness or mental anything. They were just spiritual things happening. And then I also experienced mental illness. And I think I'm at a place in my life where I've lived through enough of it that I am starting, I think I can differentiate, at least in my own life,
same at the same time.
she's finally seen a psychiatrist and has one now. We're hoping that she stays on the medication. But I don't know, you know, I'm sure some of you have been on the other side of that and have experienced being the one that doesn't want to be on the medication for one reason or another. For my family member, it's truly that he does not have insight into what's going on. He doesn't know. And when he comes out of psychosis, when we tell him, hey, you were standing and staring and then taking two steps, looking to the side and standing and staring somewhere else, and you proceeded to do that for 10 minutes without knowing that we were all talking to you and even in the room, you couldn't count three items in the room. We said, name three items in your around you just to kind of try to ground him back to reality. It's one tip that you can do when someone's in psychosis. He could name one or two. He could not name a third item, just really severe. Standing up, shouting that he was this really important figure. I'm this important figure. He's kind of like in a manic state, shouting that he's in this important figure, not sleeping. So he has had the manic and depressive areas. Another part of schizoaffective disorder and schizophrenia is that you don't feel joy often, so you kind of have that depression part. And so he's experienced both sides of that. It's just been so heartbreaking to see. And it's heartbreaking when you're that helpless, because like, I feel like most of the time we're helpless when it comes to a family member with a mental illness or ourselves. But in this case, with that component of he and his wife being in this like strong camp together that you can't really talk about much, it's so much more difficult actually. And I know it's difficult even without that component. So that's what's been going on, and it's taken a lot of my thought and care and heart, and it's just been awful, you know. Thankfully, he is now as a psychiatrist, and I hope and think he's gone through as many dips as he will, and I hope now he and his wife realize that they to live with children, to make sure their family's safe and all this, that he needs to stay on the medication. I'm hoping they've realized that through this process, and that he won't be trying to go off again and keep experiencing this. But we don't know. And you guys, the way it's affected his brain, it's just, you know, he's got that he does all the time. I call it tics. I don't know what else to call it, but it's like when he's talking to you, he's got this like click thing that he does sometimes. Sometimes it's like certain hand movements. There's a lot of just stuff going on and just memory loss, just really not remembering a lot. I got married in that time frame, and he has no awareness of that still. I mean, it's just been really hard. So I don't know, just wondering, like, do any of you guys, have any of you guys been diagnosed with schizoaffective disorder or schizophrenia? Said, when I was young, I came to follow Jesus. much more than that. And they tried to take me to a psychiatrist, but unfortunately I was of that same belief that this was spiritual, and I didn't believe that they could help me. It wasn't until about maybe 8 years ago, you guys, that I actually started taking medication. I dealt with it on my own for years and years. I got better without medication when I understood that this was not God requiring all these obsessive compulsive thoughts. I thought it was God because it started around the same time that I started to follow Jesus. Once I realized, oh, that's not God. In fact, God does not want me to OCD thoughts. He doesn't want me to have those thoughts. Like, he would love for me to be calm and at peace and of sound mind. But I didn't know that. Once I learned that, and once I learned the love of God for me, because I didn't know that either, I was free from a lot of anxiety, I didn't feel the need to cycle through thoughts. And when you don't, when you realize you don't have to do it, then it, that often helps in and of itself. It's still really hard. I know it sounds weird if you've never experienced it, but to stop a thought that you feel you need to have, it's very difficult and it takes time and tips and practice. P.S. I will link a video below. Oh, I hope I remember. I made a whole video about OCD and tips and tricks for OCD and anxiety, I think it was, specifically OCD, and I'll link that below if you've dealt with OCD and your thought patterns and not being able to stop thoughts. And this isn't just overthinking, this is like obsessive compulsive behaviors in your mind. Those tips could help you out, so I'll link that below. That was probably a year and a half ago when I did that video. So I had to come up with a lot of tips and tricks that I share in that video. I'll give you one example here. One of them is I'd have to set a timer for a thought. I realized this is not God requiring it. So let's go ahead and set a 5-minute timer. I'll think about it so that I can actually address maybe a real issue. But once that 5 minutes is up, I'm done. I'm not going to think more about it, because it will become an obsessive compulsive thing, and it's not freedom, and it's not what God wants, and it's not any of those things. So I experience a lot of freedom just from God's love and the truth. However, when I started, I had like a, what was it? I had this experience where I started having some anxiety and fears come up, and I kid you not, half of my body went numb. It started slowly, and it was, we thought I was having a stroke, because that's what happens when you have a stroke, you can't use one side of your body. I had numbness in my face, my arms, my legs, my body on one side, just from extreme stress. Isn't that the saddest thing? And so I had to go to the hospital. This is about eight plus years ago. And that's when I spoke to my family members, and they were like, Prozac is something that really helps for us on our side of the family. P.S. This is not saying you should take Prozac. Talk to your psychiatrist if you have any issues. Everybody's body chemistry is different. Medication works different for different people. But for this, our genetics, it works very well. And they encouraged me to try, and I did. And I've been so incredibly thankful, because that was when I really learned that it wasn't just spiritual, and the medication can help my thoughts slow down. The medication helps me with the OCD, and when your OCD is helped, your anxiety decreases. So lost a good amount of relationship with this family member because of these things, actually. It's been really, really hard and difficult. And it's a person that I love with every cell in my body. So, that's my story. Yeah, I'm doing much better. I'm able to live a normal life now, thank God. And so, yeah, anyway, I hope that's encouraging for you guys, some of you to hear. You are not alone if you've experienced these kinds of things. You have resources, you can talk to people, you can write about it in the comments, you can talk to people in this community, you can talk to psychiatrists, you can go to your pastor, you can talk about this and try to figure out what might be going on for you if you're experiencing some of these kinds of symptoms. So I don't have the answers. I'm just working through it and learning. But thank you for listening to my story and for listening to my family member's story. I really appreciate you guys. Struggles with mental illness. You've asked me questions about the spiritual world, about God. Like, there's been lots of conversations, and I just really appreciate you guys, and I really love you.